middle as well.
Welcome to Bennett Park for this round 22 Fortescue Premier Grade match between West Scarborough and Wanneroo Rugby Club. It is the final round of the regular season and the equation is pretty simple. West Scarborough need to win by 5 points, so a bonus point win, in order to lock up a home semi-final next week. And Wanneroo, they're looking to spoil the party. So coming off a big win last week, the Roodogs against Nedlands, they know they can be the party poopers here against West Scarborough, who are looking to finish strong this season heading into finals. My name's Jason Marrable. I'm joined in commentary for the last time this regular season by none other than Dane Lazarus, and it is an absolute gorgeous day. Not as cold as last week. The sun is out, and hoping to see some good running rugby today between these two teams. We have Jordan Kaminsky in the middle, refereeing this one as we bring the curtain down on the regular season. And at our first stoppage, we'll bring you the team sheets in a little while, but as this one's about to get... knocked on off the kickoff by Wanneroo, and we will have the first scrum of the game, and that will make West Scarborough very happy.
Yeah, not an ideal start there, Jason, for Wanneroo. High into the air. Beautiful day here. Fast deck.
No, it looks good. There's the field's not in too bad condition for Bennett Park. They'll be pretty happy with it. As I said, Dane, so you've watched a couple of West Scarborough games today. The equation is they need the bonus point win. Does that change how they go about their business today?
I think this team is happy to score points, Jason. Watch them here, Pally v. West, and they put on an absolute clinic, and here they go
well, that's
to
a
work.
Big early strong scrum from West Scarborough, getting the push on there, and it goes out wide to number nine, that's Gilbert, and they go in for the try. So they start this one off exactly how they need to, knowing that they have to score three more tries than their opponents. And early doors off the scrum penalty, it all got a little bit too easy there. The number nine, Gilvray, picks up the ball and runs it over for a five-pointer.
Yeah, very, very solid first up scrum there by West Scarborough. The likes of Nick McClellan, Eden Beach and Nico Menina in the front row. Gee whiz, and then they've got some, yeah, bit old, Jeremy Thrush, but nonetheless very smart in the scrummaging space and managed to get an early win there, Jason.
Dane, you love a player coach, don't you? We love to see it, coaching and playing. And you could definitely see the power coming through that scrum from the second row. And exactly what West Scarborough would have wanted to start this game.
Yeah, absolutely. Yes, player coach Jeremy Thrush. He might have just said, boys, one loss. He loves a farewell
match. He's had more comebacks than John Farnham, to be honest, mate. I think he's retired about 10 times and then obviously loves the game so much that he's just can't say no. I think actually this game might get him over the line for finals eligibility, which is why he's out there. And the conversion's successful. So good early start from West Scarborough, looking to lay down a marker here, heading into finals. They currently sit second on the ladder, but there is some possibility of movement if a big game happening at Tompkins Park between Palmyra and Cottesloe. Associates playing Southern Lions today as well. Southern Lions will be looking to upset the apple cart there as we get the kickoff underway. That'll be fielded, and again, a early knock on there by Brown from West Scarborough. Wanneroo will have an opportunity to come back here. This Comes out to Andrew King. And he's ragdolled to the ground by Nick McLennan. And good little tip pass there. Out wide to the number five for Wanneroo. And West have turned the ball over. And good hit there, the fly half. Kateka throws it out wide.
And it's Billy Brown. Straight up the middle.
William Brown is coming in the middle there. And oh, he just speed bumps the fullback coming up. Oh, just at the last second tries the pop pass. Oh, geez. West look in the mood today.
Yeah, Billy Brandt makes that mistake off the kickoff. And there he is, trying to make up for it. Goes the length of the field, last pass, doesn't make it. And we have a scrum under the post, but it's not over for Wanneroo. This is a danger zone for them.
And my co-commentator is just going to go and get some clarity on some of those jersey numbers for Wanneroo, not matching the team sheet we've been given, so we want to make sure we're calling the right names, as Wanneroo here have a defensive scrum right under their posts in midfield, so they'll be looking to exit cleanly as the ball goes in. Whitney Lloyd now to King, pops the ball out to Karangaroa. And a penalty for Wanneroo. West Scarborough just sensing an opportunity to apply the pressure there, coming up offside early, so the Roo Dogs will get an easier early exit. As Whitney Lloyd looks to put this one into the stands, as he does. And we get to have a look at the first line out for the Roo Dogs for the day. So just a little bit on Wanneroo. It's been a difficult season for them. They've had a lot of injuries, but they are coming off a pretty decent win against Netherlands last week. So they'll want to finish the season on a high, but that line-out's pinched by West Scarborough. Good lift, and Jeremy Thrush line-out work is working as Kateka now out wide too. Timonona now the winger. And here we are, West Scarborough. That's all too easy. Ball through the hands as the winger scores under the post. And after the line-out steal, West Scarborough finding it very easy, throwing the ball through the hands in the back line there. Didn't get the might have been Jack Neville, the fullback. Over for a pretty easy one, so they obviously know the equation today, West Scarborough, and they're not hanging around. They don't want to let the Roo Dogs get a bit of an early sniff in this one and make it hard for themselves. It's exactly the start they would have needed. And you know, Wanneroo, they'll want to finish the season on a high. Nobody wants to go out a loser, so as I said, they'll be looking to spoil the party. And they do have a lot of their players who have been injured for a large part of this season back today, so they do have a good 15 as that kick conversion is successful. And West Scarborough find themselves 14-0 up. Gets us underway. Thrushy goes up for it, jumping like a young 19-year-old, looking fresh there. As Gilbury, the try scorer, looks to set up for a box kick exit for West Scarborough. And
just took too long, Jason. Oh. Jordan's not messing around today. Haven't seen one of those all season.
No, I think he's just letting him know that he doesn't want to have slow play here. He wants to have the ball come out cleanly, so okay. Wanneroo will have a scrum feed in a good position for them now, so an opportunity to, they've sort of been blown off the park the first 7 minutes of this one, but a set piece here inside their attacking half is a good opportunity for them to test this West Scarborough backline.
And there's just a substitution there for Wanderoo early doors. Jordan Grattan has come off, and Edward Turagava has replaced him in the number 10 jersey. Early free there. Early push.
Turagava.
To Kingy.
To Andrew King, who gets absolutely monstered in the tackle and goes backwards. Great intent, and West Scarborough there coming off the line quickly. Big carry there from the number 5 from Wanneroo. And the ball goes out to the far side.
And he's missed it. Whitney Lloyd digging in for that one. Hard carry. Straight up the guts. Good support. Whitney Lloyd to King. Shifted wide. Putikapa couldn't hang on to that.
And it's poked through by Tinamana. The Roo Dogs are going backwards here in possession, but they've still managed to recycle the ball as Alec Andre Roo has taken the ground. And West have turned the ball over here, and they're looking to break the ball out wide, and the great hands, and that is Jeremy Thrush in the back line. Eat Beach with a strong carry in the midfield there. He's a hard man to bring down.
Leslie, he knows one way, that's forward. It's a bit of a slow pill here. Good counter ruck there by Wanneroo, making it slow, making it hard. But Jordan Kaminski got his hand out for a penalty. And we're just waiting on the signal there. Incorrect entry. So just coming in from the side there, Jason Wanneroo. Good intent to slow that ball down after the turnover, and I'm not too sure if the people at home could hear the extra assistant referee coming from the sideline of the West bench. Dwayne Grace assisting the referees just with an offside call. They promptly ignored him though.
Yeah, it's we're nestled in between the two benches here at Bennett Park from our commentary position, and it's great to hear the plenty of banter. And I can tell you already, the West boys, they've been pretty happy with their season because they're a bit chirpy on the bench and pretty happy at the moment. And they'll certainly be happy with the way they've started this game with a shot at goal, 10 minutes in this one to potentially take the score out to 17-0 if it's successful.
So decision to go for Pose, Jason? Do you think it's the right one?
Well, I mean, they need to finish the game 3 tries more than the Roo Dogs, but I suppose applying that scoreboard pressure as the penalty is successful. So West are 17-0 over the Roo Dogs. Yeah, and that's probably not the start they would have wanted with their starting fly half going down. The Roo Dogs as well, that'll set the game plan back as Whitney Lloyd gets us underway with a high one, and Thrushy goes up to it and knocks it on, and maybe a little bit of rust there, and the referee plays the knock on advantage, and oh geez, a big fend there from Tonga Tongo. He's taken into touch, and Tom Powell it was, sorry. Scrum for the Roo Dogs.
Yeah, we got a good angle here, Jason, from the commentary position just at the scrum. You obviously have got vast knowledge on the scrums yourself.
I am now. I haven't packed too many, but mainly from watching a lot of scrums from the sideline and from the referee's position. But let's have a look at this one. The early dominance has been from West, but it's a good one from the Roo Dogs that time, and
Putikapa Shukaki met in a solid defence at the line. PJ Avito getting his hands on the ball, a little pop pass. Wanneroo recycling.
Yeah, a little bit more speed now from the Roo Dogs in possession, and that's good as Whitney Lloyd has a little bit of a dart. Chips off a metre there. I'll have a makeshift scrum half that one with the pick and drive as they wait for their 9 to get back on the feet, and that's Andre Roo going in at halfback. Would have been a while since he's played that position, I'd imagine. And And they have a penalty advantage here, the Roo Dogs, and luckily, because that pass was not sympathetic. And Whitney Lloyd kicks that into touch, so the Roo Dogs will have an opportunity here. First line out of the game, they had it picked off by a pretty experienced and well-drilled West Scarborough line out, but this one, do West throw a jumper up here and try to disrupt Dane, or?
They've stayed down, they're looking to counter the maul, which they've done really well. Good body position. Wanneroo have held shape really well. Getting pulled out there, number three from West Scarborough. Maniina getting rid of a Wanneroo boy, but they've gone off the back. Good defence. West Scarborough looked to set early. Pillar defence. Wanneroo slow, looking to pick and go. High body position by Andre Roo. He's close. Not quite there. And an offside penalty. And try.
Yeah, try. Is that Andre Roo that's got the ball over, or?
We'll just have a look here. Hopefully on the screen, Jason. I think Andre Roo carried hard first up. Not too sure who got the second one. Lots of high fives, though. Good on Wanneroo. I think they worked hard for that one there.
It's Tom Powell getting the high fives for that one. So the front row going to work after the line out. Initially, good defensively stopping the rolling maul by West Scarborough, but just some big, strong carries from their big ball carriers. It was too much for the West defence. And Whitney Lloyd will have a crack at the conversion, but Wanneroo responded well after a bit of a shaky start the first 14 minutes. Find themselves back in this one and on the scoreboard.
Yeah, I think it was just body height there, Jason, in the defence on the goal line. Need to stay low. Managed to get a good hit, but the Tom Powell, if we're giving him the try, managed to squeeze his shoulders through the defenders and ground that ball over the line. And referee Jordan Kaminski was right on the spot there. Nice strike there by Whitney Lloyd, but sails just wide left. So the score remains 17 points to 5 with West Scarborough over Wanneroo.
So West with the restart. That's the fullback Jack Neville putting the ball high into the sun, and it's well fielded by the winger, that's Tipping Grace, who comes up with that one. And a long cutout pass now for James Brady, the outside centre. Jack Neville picks it up. Kateka now to Eden Beach, who loves carrying into contact. Big strong man. Here's Gilberay. Goes in, and an opportunity for the Roo Dogs, but it's as they look to come this short side. Neville, that's Tinamana out now to the winger, the number 11, Doug Stewart, and deputising for the big man, Jonah Placid, who's out today. Doug Stewart gets an easy one. It's a winger's try. Look up, no one in front of you. Get the last pass, run straight with speed. And West Scarborough strike back pretty quickly after the Wanneroo try.
Yeah, and it just looked like there on the blind side, that was simple play. Just draw and pass your man, Jason, and find your winger in space. He's got more speed than most. So, yeah, great work there by Doug Stewart. He did play in the trial game with the Western Force, so it's definitely one to watch today. He's on the list there that Simon Cron and the Western Force coaching crew are looking at. So, you know, that might be the first of many today for Doug Stewart. Not a bad replacement for Jonah Placid.
Shout out for the winger, Tipping Grace, recovering the, or basically winning the contested kickoff, because you may be able to see here that the sun down at Bennett Park in that corner, he would have had the sun in his eyes there. And I think that's a bit of a Bennett Park special there, hanging the ball up into the sun for the teams that aren't used to playing here week in and week out. But he did really well to bring that one down. And then West just showing, you know, they didn't hang around, did they? Three or four phases and they're under the posts as Kateka strikes that one to the left.
Yeah, Cody Grace there went high into the air. He's a big body, Jason, and in the Future Force, in the Western Force Academy. And so he's showing his skills today again. Another one that played in that trial game last week with the Western Force.
Well refereed that game, I heard, Dane.
Absolutely. The ref couldn't keep up, but no, he knew all the stuff.
And again, another strong carry from the West players as they look to come to the blind side here. Kateka puts it on the boot. That's a long kick. It's going to be fielded by Whitney Lloyd. And he keeps the ball in hand. Fends off. He's brought down. And he might be getting isolated there as West look to contest. But Roodogs recycle the ball. And it's a good pick and go. Heads up play there by the Roodogs. The number seven, Darcy Hinckley. To Andre Root.
Ed Tuagava puts it high in the air. Good contest. Oh, he gets it himself.
Getting his own kick there.
Oh, and just discipline there by the Wanneroo boys. They were offside. Ed was the kicker. They advanced before they were put onside. Ed would
be filthy at his teammates for that one. He's done all the work there. I said, how can you be offside from your own kick? But it was his teammates there just encroaching on that space. And, geez, Jordan Kaminsky, let that one go because I wanted to see him have a crack there. That's a bit of an unfortunate penalty. And West probably let off the hook there a little bit. But great little up and under by Tuagava.
A little chipper chase, was it?
Oh, I love it. Put the whistle away, Kaminsky, for that one. I reckon let him have a go. So, Wes and Eden Beach to throw in at the line out here. And they throw to the back, and it's actually picked off by the Roodogs with a good contesting. And Tuagava puts a kick on, and it's a good kick as well. And well fielded by the ball boy. So, good exit there by the Roodogs. Line out looks to be about 50-50 at the moment. Both teams have picked one off each, so good contest so far.
Yeah, just under throwing that last one there. Eden Beach, you'd want that one back.
And they're going. It's picked off again by the Roodogs, but actually I think referee Kaminsky, what's the call there, Dane? It's a free kick penalty. So
I think it might have been numbers, Jason. I haven't seen him say it was closing the gap. It might just be a numbers, just not counting. Simple math.
Yeah, let off the hook there. But player coach Jeremy Thrush, with two lineouts picked off in a row, he will be going, come on, boys, this is our bread and butter. This is what West Scarborough do. And
yeah, I think that there's a bit of positives to take away from those last two lineouts, Jason. You've got an ex-All Black Western Force player there calling the lineouts. And you managed to pick off two of them. So, yeah, don't be afraid to go to the lineouts from here on in, especially defensively, because you are rattling them a little bit. So
20 minutes into the first half, and West Scarborough have the attacking scrum on this near side, 5-6 metres into their attacking half as Gilvray feeds it. And they get the shove on, and I think they're about to get a penalty here, and they do, so they can play with the house money. But and actually, Gilbert picks it up, quickly throws it off now to the number seven. That's Matthew James, and Matthew James scores the try. And again, very similar to the first try of the game that they scored, Dane, the penalty from the scrum, and the Roodogs just not defending around that 5 metre channel. They're letting Gilbert pick the ball up and have a crack once he gets advantage.
Yeah, and he's known to snipe, and he'll find those little holes and put himself in that and get through it. And he's put Matthew James away there, and he just showed a bit of pace there. It was a 7-on-8, and PJ Vito just couldn't stay with him. And, yeah, they've just kept extending the lead now. So they do have that 3-try advantage here so far. So 4 tries to 1. At the moment.
So yeah, that one gets them the bonus point. So again, early in the commentary piece, I was just saying the equation is, if they win by 5 points, they will actually tie on points scored with UWA, who are on the bye this week, but they have a superior points difference. So they will sneak in for that second spot. And how important is getting the home semi-final for a team, Dane?
I think massive, and West Scarborough have, just as we talk, that's a converted try there. So 29 points to 5. A home field advantage is massive, and West Scarborough have had a few over the last couple of years, Jason. And this is just an absolute fortress for them. Whenever they come here, they know how to play with the wind. The sun's an issue here. The ground is hard and fast. Their players are accustomed to it, and other teams aren't. So whoever they play in that semi, if they do get it, will be in for an absolute tough game.
Whitney Lloyd gets us underway, going deep with that one, and Kateka puts it on the boot as the exit, and as you can hear, the West Scarborough bench had the old phantom touch, but actually, eagle-eyed bench over here at West Scarborough as touchy, getting the call from Jordan Kaminsky, who is definitely closer to the ball to see it. So,
a couple extra referees next year, so we don't have to worry about ref shortage. There's about 54 players on the West Scarborough bench who are all signing up.
Gilbert at the front of the line out here looks to, they go to the middle, and the boys getting up high. Gilbert throws the ball out. Nice flat pass to Kateka, who does good footwork there. And Rudogs might have, they've actually turned that one over. So that's a great effort there. Great tackle to get over the ball there by the Rudogs and win the penalty. By Kyle Sear, it was, with the turnover there. So great job by Kyle. And Whitney Lloyd puts the Rudogs down onto the attacking 22.
Gone to a five-man line out here. Darcy Hinckley cleans up the scraps well behind play. Tackled there by Matthew James, or Eden Beach, sorry, around the ankles. Head shifting it wide. Andrew King taken down. Bit slow ball behind the gain line. Andrew Rue calls for it. Andre Rue gets stripped there by Billy Brown. They pick it up, offload. Looking for the offload. Doug Stewart. Sorry, Jack Neville. Jack Neville there. Just with the inside pass and knocked on by West Scarborough. So, we're here, Jason. 25 minutes into the game. What's your take on it? Where do Wanneroo need to improve here?
I think... they definitely need to, obviously, they've given away two tries off the scrum, so it's obviously a little bit difficult when your scrum's going backwards, but if they can try and compete in that area, and I think just the pace, I mean, West Scarborough had this way of just hitting fifth gear and then going back to second and third gear, and they just have this ability to speed up the game and play at their tempo, and I think Wanneroo need to be switched on to that, but...
The rugby league feed there by Hayden Whitney Lloyd. Head to Kaki. He's hit behind the gain line yet again. Struggling to get gain line here. Slow ball, but a penalty advantage. It was a ruck. Can't use your hands in the ruck. Little pick and go near the side. Whitney Lloyd with the snipe. Oh, he's met. A strong defense there by Tina Mana.
Yeah, I would also say that West Scarborough probably winning the physical battle at the moment. A lot of the time with Wanneroo, they're going backwards in possession at times, and that's a reflection of just some of the hard tackling by these West Scarborough players. Are coming up out of the line, and when they're putting shots on, they're making them stick. They're not mucking around. And also, I want to ask you, Danny, how big is form going into finals as well? Are they emptying the tank today and saying, look, this is you know, the kind of form we need to be hitting going into next week?
I think you're in a bit of two minds, Jason. So with West Scarborough, you want to be able to make sure you come away with full points, 5 points, get that home semi. But you also want to make sure you're not taking too many injuries into the semi-final. So once they get a good lead, you would no doubt think that they would start making those substitutions, bringing their reserves on, giving them game time, because you need depth in that semi-final and finals, and they'll know that from being there last year. So they know what they need to do. They've been there. They're looking to go back-to-back this year. Started shaky, but yeah, they hit their straps when it counted. And just a bit of lack of cohesion there by Wanneroo. Head to Agava, passing into no man's land. Number 5, Julian Cron, gets over, well over the gain line. Takes 2-3 to take him down. Quick ball, Whitney Lloyd snipes. He's got a bit of support with him, but no halfback. The biggest halfback in Premier Grade rugby. Passes it to Kaki. James Walker. Yes, James Walker manages to secure that penalty. Bit isolated there from Tukaki. Up, and he's called them also off their feet, holding on. Probably everything in between that as well.
Yeah.
So a number of options there for...
Take your pick with that one. I've pinged you for about 3. So Kateka will look to find touch with this penalty. Sails over the head of the commentary team here, and this is like a summer's day. This is absolutely gorgeous down here at Bennett Park, and hopefully we have similar Saturdays like this. 2 more rounds. Well, there's no more rounds to go in the regular season, but next week will be the semi-final, and an exciting time heading into a big grand final at Tompkins Park this year on September the 2nd, as Beach looks to throw the line in, and they take this one in the middle, and Gilbray gives it to Kateka. It's brought down well in the tackle. Gilbray gives it to
big number 4, Leslie. That's a strong carry by the number 4 there.
Kateka throws a long pass out, and it's intercepted by the Roo Dogs. And it gets a little bit scrappy. They throw this one back, but they look to move it. Big Andre Roo, he'll tuck and run and take it into contact. To Agava calling for it from Whitney Lloyd, and he switches and goes the other way as he saw the defence rushing up. Line speed from that West defence has been good for the first 30 minutes of this one. Lloyd looks. So they go back, King on the line side, throws it to touch, but it's Storz, cleans it up. Whitney Lloyd, good hands there, but it's always belted in the tackle. It's gone down awkwardly. And
Avito gets rid of one, met by Leslie. And a bit of concern here for number 9, Whitney Lloyd. He stayed down after that big collision. He was quite low to the ground there, so.
Yeah, it was just awkward, really. His legs kind of got caught under him, and hopefully he's okay, because he did get hit big, but it was more that his body position was just in a bit of a weird, awkward way that he went down. And I think hopefully we'll have a bit of a stoppage here, 31 minutes into this one, and hopefully Whitney Lloyd's okay. And they're just struggling to get a bit of continuity in attack, Dana. Why is that? Is that the West defence coming up, muscling up, putting the big shots on? Or
yeah, it's just their line speed. A bit of a... not cohesive by Wanneroo's attack, as we see William Brown, he got a yellow card there. I think that might have been for the tackle, might have been just a bit high in contact, nothing more, but I don't think that'll be too bad for the West Scarborough team. We just hopefully wait. Hayden Whitney Lloyd's okay, so there's a bit of a break here in play. Back to that question, Jason. Yeah, just a bit of lack of cohesion on attack. They're not really able to find the weak shoulder of West Scarborough defence. They're coming up really well together, good line speed, and making their first up tackles. And that's putting a lot of pressure on Wanneroo. Their forwards like big Andre Roo, Braden Karangaroa, PJ Avito, they're having to do a lot of work behind the gain line just to secure it and not able to put them into space where they can actually make meters. So yeah, a bit to work on there. Steve Kavanagh, who is the head coach of Wanneroo, will have a few things to think about and a few messages, no doubt, at halftime to clean it up and get them going forward again. And we see Hayden Whitney Lloyd doing well to walk off the field here, and a good round of applause. And he's going to be replaced by the young gun, Tom Crofts in number 21 jersey. Tom recently went away with the Rugby WA under 18 state team and is one to watch. Really good young halfback, lots of skill, kicking, running, passing, he's got it all. And he'll get a lot of game time here, 33 minutes into the first half.
Turagava from the penalty for the high tackle. And an opportunity here for the Roodogs. If they can get a try, get some points on the board in the last 7 minutes of this first half, it might just give West Scarborough something to think about, because they are just 3 tries ahead. They, as I said, they need that bonus point to secure the home final. That's their goal today. And Crofts goes to Turagava and wide to the... And this is number 6, Karangaroa, for the Roodogs, carrying strong there. Andre Roux to Turagava. Crofts now wide to Bully.
He's come off his right wing, Jason, to link in with his opposite winger. Crofts, good short pass to Sear, coming back on the angle. Nice long pass to Turagava.
And big number 16 there, Tom Powell, the try scorer, Turagava. This is better from the Roodogs. Big long pass out to the wing now. Cut out pass, defence is strong from West, and they compete at the breakdown. And not legally, says referee Kaminsky, and the Roodogs have another penalty. That was better from the Roodogs. We talked about the speed of attack and that continuity. That was good, and I like seeing Bully come in off his wing as well. I think that was his first touch for the game, so we want to see more from him. As Turakaba puts that one out for the line out, about 7 metres out. So they scored their first try of the game from a similar position, and late in this first half, they'll be looking to just upset West Scarborough here, make him a little bit of uncomfortable. And the Roodogs bring it down for the rolling maul. It's going backwards though.
They're extremely high there, Wanneroo, so not able to get any forward momentum, and taken down there by Eden Beach. Slow ball, Tom Croft, Turagava. Tukaki couldn't hang on to it, but they had a penalty advantage and they came back to it there. Not too sure what Jordan Kaminsky has called there, Jason. Yeah, a few signals there, but unable to decipher that one.
Penalty count for West just starting to tick over now as well. That's 3 in a row here in their attacking, in Wanneroo's attacking 22. As they'll try and set up that line out again. So you're saying if they go to the rolling maul here, Dane, the Roodogs just need to get a little bit lower?
Yeah, just in their setup, Jason, the players coming in to steal that ball, but well, great nil play there by Leslie and West Scarborough. Got up, competed, double bluffed. Wanneroo took it a bit easy. Thought it was a bit of a given. Gilray back to Koteka. And cleared, still inside the 22. So another opportunity here for the Roodogs. They were just a bit lazy going up there, Jason, a bit slow. And
yeah, they got Leslie up quite well. I don't think Thrushy's been lifted in the line out yet. He seems to be doing the lifting duties. And here's Crofts to Turagava, to King.
Now to Kaki, to Bully.
Who's Bully? Does well to bring it in, Bully, and he's going to break. He's got absolute speed. Gas goes for the wing, and the Roodogs score. 3 minutes from the halftime break. And actually, the line out further out from the 22 meant that rather than go for the rolling maul, they good speed, good passing from Turagava to King. And then we're just saying only a few moments ago that the winger Bully had his first touch, and he looks to be quick, and he showed us his wheels there. He's absolutely rapid and did really well to collect the ball. He juggled it a little bit of a circus act. And try by the Roodogs, so that takes away the bonus point for West Scarborough. So I wonder, going into halftime, will they be nervous, Dane?
No, I don't think so, Jason. I think I think they will know what they need to do, how to fix it, and they've got class all over the field. So they do have the wind behind them currently, West Scarborough, so that could be a factor playing into the breeze into the second half. But they know this ground, they know how to play, and yeah, I think that'll just jog them a bit. I think they'll come out firing from this kickoff, as we see Ed Turagava line up this kick, left footer from the left-hand touchline.
So as it stands, Dane, it'll be UWA versus Wests in the semi-final. The question we don't know yet is who will be hosting it. And there's a fair few UWA supporters down watching this game because they know what it means and they'll be cheering for the Roodogs. But a little bit of a preview. Who's the favourite in that semi-final?
If you look at last year's Grandy, Jason, and then you look at the form coming into that match, you'd have to say West Scarborough will be favourites for that one. I know UWA have a number of injuries. And so they'll find it tough, but they have a good coach, good quality team, and wow.
That's
Cody Grace went a high again, manages to collect it, and they're back on attack, West Scarborough. Jack Neville to James Brady, cut low by Ed Turagava, gets back to his feet. Gilbarry to Teka, Maniena to Beach, hit in a strong contact.
Yeah, Wes looking to get that bonus point back before halftime.
Tino Mana to James Walker. James Walker secures it for his team. Big Jeremy Thrush, does a goose step. First time in his career he's done that. Wouldn't want to be doing that too often, just carry. Kateka, Neville, wide to Matthew James. No one on the blind side. Good numbered up there by Wanneroo. There's Nick McLennan. His probably first carry for the day. And he looks to score from there. He'll say it's a 50 metre if he does. Gilvary, Kateka, James Walker looking for work, but it's
ripped
just
out in the tackle. And the Roodogs have it. So good spell of defence there by the Roodogs, staying strong before half time. King puts it on the boot. It's not going to find touch. And that is James Brady who collects that one. It comes back inside, runs into contact. He's brought down by Turagava there, and Wes will have another crack in the dying seconds of this first half. We're into referee time now, and that is Leslie bringing the ball forward.
And an advantage there, not rolling away.
James Brady taking the ball into contact again, the big outside center. He's a big man. And the Roodogs disrupting there at the breakdown legally, but referee Jordan Comiskey comes back for the earlier penalty. And you can hear the West coaching staff here saying, go for the corner. And interestingly, Kateka is going to go into the corner into the sun. So that means that your jumpers are bringing the ball down. Like, is that a bit of a... I've thought that one through, or is that just that they must have a plan? Patch of grass out there is a bit nicer, or
it must be the cage, Jason. You put the team in the cage and you score every time, so
yeah,
could be a tactic. Who knows?
Maybe they think, well, the Roodogs will also have to look into the sun, so obviously trust their line out. As we hear the beach goes to the middle, and the Roodogs actually steal that one well. So the line out battle has been great today as Turagava puts the ball on the boot, and it's a good long kick, comes all the way out to halfway, bounces a couple of times.
To Pinny Grace, 14. Beats one, gets into Kingy. Kingy meets him in strong defence. The old Wiley.
Got numbers
veteran
here. And good cut out pass. Oh, great cut tackle down low. And Kaminsky has his arm out. Might be for not rolling, I think. And so they have a penalty again. And big number eight. He's coming away with it here. James Walker. I thought there might have been a knock on, but.
That ball just went forward, yes. I think
forward,
that was a touchy support.
Commentators saw that one, Dane, right here in front of us.
Jason, you're a quality referee, and I think you assisted that call, so for sure.
I'm a much better referee on the couch at home watching it on Stan Sports than I am running around there on the field, Dane. It's the eyes are okay, it's the legs that are the problem. As West Scarborough. Now, deep into the referees' time here in this first half, they'll have an attacking line out on the 22. Beach will throw this one in. And it's been a great contest at the line out. I've really enjoyed watching both teams go at it in the line out. Plenty of steals, but good steals as well by the jumpers. But this one they bring down with Leslie, but that one is not straight. And referee Jordan Kaminski signals half time. So it's the home team, West Scarborough, 29-10. They need one more try, Dane, to get that bonus point, and we'll come back and see if they can do it here in the second half.
back here live at Pettit Park, Jason, for this Fortescue Premier Grade match, round 22, West Scarborough versus Wanneroo. Halftime score, 29 points to 10, West Scarborough over Wanneroo, as we have kickoff here. Kicking it deep into the sun. James Walker, big carry into Andre Roux. And it's stripped out there by number 14. Cade Begg. And just knocked on. Knocked on again close to the line there, Jason. So, extremely fast start there.
I know, I'm still having my lunch. My halftime halftime snakes. And again, if Wanneroo can come out and put a try on early, as they almost did there, West will definitely get uncomfortable. As I said, they need to get one more try. So, good quick start by the Rudolphs. Good intent. As I said, you don't want to lose. You don't want to go out a loser, right? They're going to want to win their last game of the season for sure.
And they've got everything to play for as well, Jason. That wooden spoon is something you do not want in your trophy cabinet. So,
no.
They need a win. Kalamunda need to lose. So, Joondalup play Wanneroo today. Joondalup play Kalamunda today, sorry. And I know Wanneroo will be begging Kalamunda to get over the line. Joondalup to get over the line. And just an advantage there, going off his feet, was number 9, Hubert Milgarry. And a big carry there and a try time. Just muscling his way over there. That looked like PJ Avito. Get confirmation of that. But Jason, there it was. That's the start that Wanneroo wanted.
Great start from Wanneroo, and their bench got up for that one. They were happy. So a little bit of cup of coffee at halftime. They've come out firing and a great start. So it's West Scarborough just, well, all credit to Wanneroo there. Great intensity. Won the line out. Just muscled up and they're in this game.
Yeah, PJ Avito there picked it up on that blind side. Had some defenders to beat there. Got rid of one and then just muscled his way over with two on his back. And a really good grounding, hard on the ground, and he got up with a bit of enthusiasm. So 29 points to 15, Jason. Kick to come. This is actually anyone's game here. I wonder if they can turn it on with the wind behind their back. It could make it a very, very uncomfortable for West Scarborough. Ed Turagava unable to convert. So 29 points to 15 at Rains. And a really fast start there.
Yeah, and it'd be fair to say the Roodogs are a good team, Dane, and they've just had a bit of a nightmare season with injuries. And a few of their big players, like Ethan Riley, missed a large part of the start of the season as he was away on other duties, and a lot of injuries, but they're a good team. This is a team that finished with the Division 2 championship last year. As really impressed with West Scarborough, it's Tip and Grace, every going up and making a contest out of every restart. It seems they just go to him. He's obviously got a really good jump on him, so give him a running jump and contest, make the Roodogs keep them honest on the restart, make sure they're throwing a man up. As we have a West Scarborough scrum after the Roodogs knock on. So West Scarborough 29, Wanneroo 15, as McLennan just loses his footing on this side. What are you seeing at scrum time, Dane? Educate me.
So on that one there, just looked like both front rows were a bit unstable. Quite a big gap as well. And Nick McLennan got a pretty good hit on it. I think this is number 17, Roo McLeod, on for Wanneroo on the tight head there. Yes, number 17, Roo McLeod. And he just couldn't hold the hit. So that's my opinion. I think Nick could have got rewarded for that. But we reset. And Roo McLeod got nice and low under Nick McLennan, making it a bit uncomfortable. But
Here we go. We've seen this. Gilroy to Kateka to Tiamana. And the ball went backwards, so they got an opportunity here. And this is Tip and Grace. He shows some great speed. Now goes out to the fullback, Jack Neville. And ball comes loose at the death. And the Roodogs, strong carry there. So they get away with one on the handling error there. But some good speed by the winger and fullback as Turagava puts that one on the boot and clears.
Yeah, with that breeze behind, yeah, they can hit it long, get it up in the air and take pressure off their own line, and that's what they weren't able to do in the first half. But here we have West Scarborough with the ball, 40 metres out from the Wanneroo line. Their throw-in, looking into that sun. And they've gone again with the short line-out. We can see Matthew James, James Walker as well, spread out wide. In the wide channel there is James Walker. And they put Leslie high into the air. Good, clean ball. Tinamana. He's met at the gain line there. And we shift it to Kateka, to Brady. Brady stopped there by King. Here's Walker in that wide channel. He was set up there from the line-out. Gilvary to Billy Brown. He had 10 minutes rest, so he's fresh. Takes two to bring him down. Oh, and just a knock-on there. So he's just not having the greatest of days there with ball in hand, William Brown. And a bit of push and shove. Darcy Hinckley completely out of his weight class there. Wouldn't be taking on Money Hina there if I was the size of Darcy Hinckley, but Darcy isn't going to back down.
Was he picking a fight? He was hoping somebody else might finish for him. But I'm going to do a half-time score check for you, because I know that you wouldn't want to go anywhere else. You should be absolutely pinned here to Bennett Park as Jeremy Thrush takes a little bit of a break on the ground there. So Palmyra up 26 points to 7 against Cottesloe. So Cottesloe got a little bit of work to do there if they want to make finals. They need some results to go their own way. And in the other game, that really matters in terms of a finals position. Associates are up 18 to 7 against Southern Lions at the Boneyard, but that's still a little bit uncomfortable for Associates, 18-7. We know that Southern Lions are probably the banana skin team this year. They've beaten Cottesloe. They can, on their day, take a scalp, and they've been fun to watch this year. The Southern Lions have come a long way and been really competitive. So, as it stands, still all to play for in this second half across this Premier Grade competition. The long 22-round season has been a fantastic season. Loads of teams in contention to finals up until this week. We've seen some great rugby and some great Western Australian talent as well.
Yeah, we just had Jeremy Thrush do his customary 5-minute break. He was a bit tired, so smart little play there.
Yeah, I think he did the old, the laces are off on the boots. Just got to retie the laces.
And tell the physio to forget stuff in the tent. And
sucking a few big ones.
As PJ Arvito off the back, gets it off to Tom Croft. He beats one. Tackled by Matthew James. James Walker's trying to slow that one down. Slow ball here. And Jeremy Thrush taking two with him there. And the pick and go from 60 metres out is an interesting tactic. Tom Croft is marshalling the troops.
It's a set up for the box kick. And no, it goes back to Turagaba, who puts it on the boot. It's a low one out to the fullback, Jack Neville. And he takes it out. He's met strong in the tackle there by the Roodogs. So the Roodogs this half, 40 minutes left in their season. They've come to play. They're not going down quietly. There's a bit of bite and a bit of bark left in them. As West Scarborough set up. And
there's Maniana. He carries well. Eden Beach with him. Wrestle to the ground just inside Wanneroo's half. Slow ball. Everyone's looking for it. Jeremy Thrush pointing where the ball should go. High into the air. That wind is holding the ball up. And Bully.
And here's
Bully. That's a foot race.
There we go. It's going to be a foot race. Has he got the speed?
He's making things
uncomfortable here at Bennett Park. And he, a nice dive for the celebration as well. And a little bit of afters with the winger Tip and Grace, but that is one fast man, Dane. He has some absolute wheels, and things all of a sudden in this second half not going to plan for West Scarborough. And early in the first half, they got off to a flyer with some quick tries, looked really comfortable, and now it's gone a little bit quiet behind us on the pig pen.
Absolutely, but they just got a couple subs coming on, and absolute quality subs. Number 20, Simeone, Vutiverta. And
Chris Tuatara, and yeah. he's about a foot and a half away from us, and he is a big human.
And as Heath Tessman says, the field's just about to get better looking.
He's a big dude.
So Chris Tuatara has played for the Western Force, multiple caps for the Force, so he'll come on and add that experience to the team. So they're not short of experience on the field, so they'll know what they need. As you said, Jason, they do have a spot in the semi. It's just a matter of home or away, and that's converted there. So 22 points to 29. Wanneroo have come back from 17-0 down, Jason, after about 10 minutes.
And bounced back. They've done really good. It's a great response here in the second half, and I'm not going to lie, there's a few students around as well watching this one with UWA on a bye, and I think they're honorary Roo Dogs for the day, cheering these boys on, hoping that they can do the job here against West Scarborough and secure the home final at the Library. And off the restart, that's Nico Mananana.
And yeah, just coming off is William Brown and number 11, Doug Stewart.
Tinamana did really well there with his feet, and can take up to big Leslie. Number 4, Regan Leslie. He's got a lot of work today, and he wrestles that one to ground. And a counter ruck is good by the Roo Dogs, but it's cleaned up really well. And it's actually come loose now for the Roo Dogs, and Turagava puts it on the boot and grubbers it into touch, but West Scarborough are a little bit at 6 and 7s in this second half, Dane. They've not come out the way that team talk from Dwayne Grace would have. I don't know, what are you seeing? What's changed?
I think that wind is a factor here, Jason. They're not able to get out of their half with a clearing kick, so they're having to run everything. And you saw when they put a kick up here, Bully got under it, and then he just found a space and took off. So they're just not able to relieve that pressure. So here they are deep in their half. They have to secure the line out first and foremost, and then find ways to get over the gain line with each carry. As soon as you don't do that and the defense can go forward, that's when it starts to get really, really difficult. We have a player down in back parade there for Wanneroo, just coming from the line out. And you can see they're going backwards, Jason, which makes it very, very difficult to find the loose, to find the gaps in the defense. So here the pass goes back to Kateka. Bully. Oh no, we had that from Storts. Storts puts the chip and chase in.
Not a bad little chip as well.
Finds grass.
Behind there.
Jack Neville's watching that run deep. And
I tell you what,
that one.
Very close. It was a good, really clever little kick there by Storts. Just finding that space and.
Yeah, I think it just dribbled over the dead ball line, Jason, so that means we come back. Well, we have an option of a 22 dropout or a scrum where he kicked it from, so no doubt they'll take the scrum, and looks like we'll have a substitution here. Number 23, Jai Edwards-Tilby, coming on for Wanneroo, and number 23, Walter Kateka, coming on for West Scarborough. Walter looks like he's coming on for Tane Kateka.
So for our viewers, can you give us a not rating on that wind, Dane? What do you think? Is that a 15 or?
You are the weatherman, Jason, so I'll leave that for you, the gust expert.
It's actually picking up in this second half now. It's going across the field from our position to the far side, so about 15, 20 knots on that one. And it does seem to be assisting the Roo Dogs in this second half as it is to their back. Plenty of time in this one for West to a couple of big changes. So the Katekas, they brothers, Dane, cousins, or?
I think everything, Jason. Couldn't guess which ones, but definitely family. So they'll know how to work together, even though they've replaced. So it's a bit of a like for like. They both have the same skill sets. But this is where I think West Scarborough can get dominance at scrum time, get the penalty from the scrum, but Wanneroo put the heaps of pressure in.
Yeah, wow. Commentator's curse there.
Absolutely.
And, geez, you can hear as well from the Roo Dog players and the bench. They've got a sniff here. They sense an opportunity.
Yeah, so I think that might have been just a little switch off there. But big Andre Roux, his chest got about 10 times bigger after that scrum, getting the penalty.
He's gotten through a mountain of work today. He's carried a lot of balls and made a lot of tackles. So he's a big man, but he also gets around the field, gets involved. He's it's not just the scrummaging. He's a hard man to tackle, as Turagava, with that 20-knot wind at his back, he's going to have a crack at the post here and try and get it within 25 points. So both teams are actually scored four tries apiece. So West are going to need three tries here in this second half, with the Roux Dogs scoring no more. It's actually just those conversions that separate the two teams now.
And a penalty kick there, Jason, that West Scarborough had in the first half.
So Darcy Hinckley's come off for the Roux Dogs as well. Bit ginger. He's got a lot of tape on him, that man. He's held together with a fair bit of tape, but hopefully he's okay. But that might be his shift for 2023.
And we're going to head to Turagava, lining up the kick on the angle. Puts it high, has the breeze behind him.
And he's successful as
guides
well.
Guides it through with ease. So 29 points to 25, Jason. And as you mentioned about Darcy Hinckley, he, again, fights out of his weight class week in, week out, come through the junior ranks and played state under 15 for junior gold, won the championship back in 2016, and has gone on to represent the state at a number of age grade levels. So good work with him, and we look to see him next year again.
And again, really well contested restart by West Scarborough, and Gilvray goes around the corner. Ball in hand, he's brought down by Bulu, but does well, and West get possession back after the restart, which is always to Atara. Takes the ball up, and Beach brings it up for West Scarborough, looking to strike back. Goes out to Neville, the fullback.
Walter Kateka, good pass.
Space outside here, gives it to Tip and Grace, the winger, and the defence is coming over back inside to the big man from West Scarborough, and they strike back. And a fantastic try and a great job by Tip and Grace to throw the ball back inside to the big man. Didn't catch the number because there's a fair few West Scarborough players. It was James Walker on the inside. Great support play by, and it was actually Dane. It was the getting the restart. I've just tripped over my own tongue there. Getting possession off the restart. They've done it all day. Tip and Grace. Every time there's a kickoff, every time there's a restart, they're winning the ball back, and that's huge for them. And now they've chipped away at the task of getting three. Now they're one try ahead. And 34-25 on the scoreboard. And I don't know about you, but I think there's more tries to come for both teams in this game. It's been open. It's high scoring. Love to see it.
Absolutely. And that was right in front of the clubhouse, and they went crazy there for James Walker. And the kick goes up by Walter Kateka. Just stays misses. Left of that post. And the score remains 34 points to 25. West Scarborough just in the lead. Like you said, they need another two tries to get that bonus point and secure a home semi-final here at Bennet Park. And Dwayne Grace is saying, we'll play wherever, we'll win wherever.
plenty of time on the clock for that one. So, Dane, last round of the regular season, I'm going to ask you to pick a highlight. We've watched a lot of rugby. You've been on Stan. You've got promoted. Some of us have been burrowing away on YouTube and haven't got the call up, but seen a lot of rugby. We've seen some Colts, we've seen some women's rugby on YouTube, even some championship. What's been your highlight of the 2024 season, some of the standouts?
Well, no doubt that game that we were down in Mandurah, where there was some gigantic tackles.
Yes.
From Sonny Bill, we called him, we nicknamed him.
Yep.
He was outstanding. I was with a Stan game earlier this year here, Palmyra versus West Scarborough, where West Scarborough got up over Pally and they were in red hot form. Some of the women's games were outstanding. Some named players like Rosie McGeehan for Kalamunda women. She's one to look for in the future. And just generally rugby, Jason. Rugby's always the winner here, year in, year out. We always have the issues, but when rugby's on, everyone's happy.
Nice
Well, you've stolen most of mine, so well done. Completely agree. That game in Mandurah in the championship was an absolute cracker as West Scarborough have the ball here and are looking to score more tries.
They're getting put under pressure there. Lots of pressure put on by number 25, Jake Smith. And very slow ball here, and they're going backwards. Nick McLennan, not often do you see him go backwards in tackles. Slow, slow ball. Picked up by Leslie, offloaded.
Oh, great offload Beach. Now here's Gilvery. He's got defenders to beat. Puts a big step on. The fullback comes over and makes the cover tackle. That's Storts. But West Scarborough, big Jeremy Thrush shifts the ball. Quick, good hands by the veteran. And West Scarborough now sensing an opportunity here. And a little bit of a knock on there in contact. So just
plenty of time to play here, Jason.
Oh, plenty of time. Dwayne Grace, he's right near us. He didn't look, he doesn't look stressed. He doesn't look too bothered. He's, we might check back in about 10 minutes time if it stays like this. We'll get a bit of a pulse or a heart rate update. But he doesn't seem too bothered. They're confident. They're a well-drilled team, West Scarborough, and that's why they find themselves where they are on the ladder. They've been one of the teams to beat all year.
And you got to remember, Jason, that they are the reigning champions. They won at Wanneroo last year, Kingsway Reserve or Sporting Complex.
And then won every single game after that. They went undefeated after the split last year.
Yes. And they started rough this year.
They did.
A couple losses. Everyone wrote them off. They were bottom of the table. Everyone was saying, oh, they're done. And here we find themselves back in the semi-finals, guaranteed a semi-final spot.
Yep.
And one win away from the big dance where we know anything can happen.
So they actually lost their first six games of the season. They were defeated. And then since then, I think they've gone on a run. I think they've only lost once, I'm guessing, since then. They're pretty much... So slow start is probably a bit of an understatement. Maybe pre-season at Bennett Park starts in May. And look, they know that. And I suppose Jeremy Thrush is probably not keen to play 22 rounds of rugby this year. So he's come on for the last five or six rounds to get that finals eligibility. And he's still out there as well at 57 minutes. He's still going.
I thought you were going to say 57 years of age, Jason.
No, he does work in the same building as me, so I would never say that, Dane. And here's King for the Roo Dogs. And geez, good clear out there by the Roo Dogs. It's a penalty, actually. It's Turagaba. So come back for the penalty there as the player not rolling away.
So just an easy opportunity to get up their half here. Jason, a penalty which didn't need to be given away. And they can put it up into the breeze and stick it inside West Scarborough's half. Give themselves an opportunity to attack. Ed Tuagava, it's low, it's ugly, but it's in touch. So just inside the half of West Scarborough. Let's say on the line there, actually. On the line's in. And 50 metres here to score a try and get back within one try, or one score, of West Scarborough. Good line-out take, shifted by Tom Croft, Ed Turagava. There's Avito, he's in the midfield. James Walker just couldn't hold on to that ball. Long pass by Turika.
Oh, there's an opportunity here, Dave, for West. Turmana cleans one up. It was the Matildas playing at the moment. It was great work chipping it up off the boot, and West Scarborough sniffs something here. Gilvray works to get to the ruck. Throws it out to the big number eight. Carrying the ball there, that's Walker. And good pop pass there to Leslie, who's been great today. I've been really impressed. And he refuses to go down and chips off about 10 metres. And it just slows down a little bit, so they keep it in nice and tight. There's the big man, the number 17, Nick McLennan, I think, getting that one. A bit hard to see. And it's big man Jeremy Thrush goes over for the try, and you can hear at the pig pen, they absolutely love that. I think he ran from 20 metres calling for the ball. And just like he did for the Western Force this year, scores a try. try for his team when they need it. So that puts them two tries ahead. They need one more to get that bonus point. Again, 20 minutes on the clock, but the player coach, Jeremy Thrush, going over. You're not going to stop him. He's still a big human. No, he's a veteran, but he's going to be pretty hard to bring down when he's running onto the ball like that. As the conversion successful for West Scarborough, they go out 41-25. So one more try needed, but as I said, 20 minutes to go. It's 34 Palmyra Cottesloe 19. So Cottesloe, bit of work to do on that one. And Associates are up 21-12 against Southern Lions at the Boneyard. So that one is still a bit uncomfortable, but...
Had a bit of a loss here, Jason. Sorry to cut you off there, but we got Captain PJ Avito. He's coming off, carried off, supported off by his teammates. He's done a mountain of work today. Scored a try himself, and here we big loss with him.
Oh, McLennan gets the tip on from Thrush and is met by a hard shoulder by Andrew King. And Kateka throws the ball out now to Amana, and here is Tipping Grace, puts it on the boot, is tackled after the tackle, kicks that one into touch.
And in the replacement there for PJ Avito, Avito is number four, Hayden Alsop, young player there. Hayden goes to Lake Joondalup Baptist College, loves his rugby, and we'll see him give
just
a good effort
thrown
here.
There, and Eden Beach, who's done well, but it's turned over, was holding on to the ball there. Eden Beach, he's done well today, Eden, because their hooker, Ford Hemi, is away with the Western Force, and he's on a plane to South Africa.
Bloemfontein, tough place.
So they've done. He's done well to shoulder a fair bit of responsibility, the hooker today, as Turagava puts that one into touch.
Yeah, Bloemfontein's a tough place to go play rugby, Jason. Chris Heiberg mentions it all the time. You learn how to scrum there. You learn how to play forwards rugby there.
Well, we saw the Wallabies when they went. They got pretty dusted up when they went earlier this year. So it'll be interesting to see how the Western Force tackle that tour. And then they'll be bringing those boys back to the West for a couple of games after the Rugby WA Grand Final. So we could see a few of these players in that Western Force squad when they head back as the ball comes out of the ruck. But referee Kaminsky goes back for a penalty.
Yeah, so just not a clear release there. James Walker picked up the player on the floor with the ball, but just didn't get a clear release for Jordan Kaminsky's liking, so came back for the penalty. Ed Turagava can put it deep into the 22 here and look to make it very uncomfortable for West Scarborough. They do need one more try, Jason, as you mentioned, for that bonus point win.
That's a good kick by Turagava, and he's been impressive coming on pretty much 2 minutes into the game with the starting fly half Grattan going down injured. He's come on and actually steered the Wanneroo ship really well, and he's been very good with the boot as well. That chip and chase that was brought back was great to see, but been impressive as well, as a bit of a wobbly line out, but they still come away with it, the Roo Dogs, as they set up the rolling maul. But referee Kaminsky will probably say, I think actually Big McLennan's come through there, and Turagava throws it out now, and Bully just puts the ball down, and it's going to be a bit of a foot race. It's put on the deck here by Wes, and oh, this is all getting a little bit scrappy, but gee, it's fun as the fullback Storz throws it out to Bully, and now let's see this man run. Gives it back to Storz. He puts it on the boot again, and that's kicked out on the full, but that was a little bit of fun there. It was fun to watch because you didn't know which way that was going to go, but West Scarborough probably get the net win there as Eden Beach will throw the ball in 10 metres into the West Scarborough attacking half. And Leslie goes up very high, great on the lift there, and
Chris Tuatara taking some work off his forwards. Comes in for the carry, nice and close. Gilvary, Kateka, bad pass. Walker cleans it up under pressure, but he gets through two. Gets it off.
Tipping Grace, great little pop up there. Getting the hand free. And could he go all the way here, Tipping Grace? He's going left, he's going right. Puts a step on. He's brought down. Gets around all of them. And that is the bonus point try that West needed. And here come the hot steppers. He went left, he went right, he went left, he went right. And Tipping Grace.
Wow.
Tepene Grace, maybe how you say it.
Cody Tepene Grace.
Tepene Grace, wow. And I was he's been great today as well, the 14. Scored a couple of tries, set up one. It's been great on the restart. And that's probably the pick of the bunch. And that puts that extra 1 point in the column now for West Scarborough, which means they, if it stays the same, or they score any more unanswered, they will be hosting back here next Saturday. And you and I will be commentating on it.
Sounds good, Jason.
I just told you, you weren't aware of that, but I think I just stitched you up for that. No, we won't actually.
No, unfortunately. We got work to do, Jason. Semi-final weekend. No rest for the wicked.
WA will be out
everywhere.
That I had to work that weekend, that Saturday.
But yeah, well, Walter Kateka taking it really far back. Just testing his distance out. Chips it and puts it over there for 48 points to 25, Jason. So they've gone 19 points unanswered.
Yeah, this game's gone back and forward. So we've had probably a 20-minute period where the Roodogs, you would have thought they were second on the table the way they come out of the second half and put on a couple of tries really quickly. But now West Scarborough in the last 10 minutes have replied. So it's been a bit of a seesaw affair. But one try will still be uncomfortable for West Scarborough. So they won't want to rest on this as they put the restart nice and high. And it's actually recovered by the Roodogs. As Big Nut Croft goes to the big number 17.
McLeod is out here to beg. Or see her, sorry. Croft to Regava. Out to Bully and just long.
Needed that gust of wind to keep it in, but he did have a penalty there, so referee Jordan Kaminsky brings us back. This beautiful winter's day here at Bennett Park. You would have thought it's summer. The sun is shining. The pig pen is full.
We have
a lot of the home supporters here enjoying what they're seeing. It's been a very entertaining game of rugby, as it generally is in the Fortescue Premier Grade. And might be a few nervous moments as I've just gone a little bit quiet here as the Roodogs have a penalty and have taken it down 10 metres out from their line.
And I think there's going to be a replacement here for West Scarborough. Number 18, Callum Young, is coming onto the field. Just wondering though who they're taking off. And it looks like the number 15, Jack Neville.
He's been good as well today. Good shift by him, so he's pretty rapid. He'll ice those hamstrings getting ready for next week as the Roodogs bring it down. And defensively contested well by West Scarborough as Big Jeremy Thrush starts to swim through and see if he can disrupt that a little bit more. And
it looks very messy.
I don't know,
Jason,
if that ball's going to come out of there. It looks like they're all dancing, and it's actually
they go forward now.
They're actually still going forward now, but brought down by the Wanneroo player, and to be a scrum for West Scarborough. So
timing must have been impeccable there, Jason, from the counter defence of West Scarborough off the line-out, the mall defence. Looked like the player might have just been in the air, but they got the shove on and Jordan Kaminsky let it play. Yeah, I think you're right, early shove.
I was just miming that. I think might have got a, but you know, it's a game of, it's those little one percenters, it's whatever you can get away with. So again, if the referee's not calling it, you take it. And they're probably, the line-out has been really interesting today. It's been a great contest. The scrum as well. So
West Scarborough, they're known for their set piece, and that's probably something that they'll feel as though they can compete with any team on their day, whether it be UWA or Palmyra in the future. The set piece is where they'll think they've got a bit of an edge, and they certainly show it with the scrum as the ball pops out, and Gilray does really well. Pops it out now to, it's Kateka who gets it on the hop, goes to Tip and Grace. Here's a new substitute, comes in, puts a fend on, and does really well there, the number 18, to take the ball forward, and that's
Simi here, number 20, carrying the ball with the big dreads. Kateka, Tuatara, Tinamana.
Big, strong carries, hard man to bring down.
They're going end to end, up the middle.
Good strong clear out there as well by West Scarborough, coming from a long way out.
Leslie.
And that's Leslie as well. He's got through a mountain of work today. He's been really impressive. Regan Leslie now to Jeremy Thrush, the try scorer. Still going at 70 minutes. He's going to last the whole game. And oh, it's almost picked off there, but. And we're going to come back for a penalty there. And not sure. Few bodies in the way there to see what happened.
Looked like a forward pass though there, Jason. I think Jordan Kaminsky said it was forward pass first, then a knock on. Couldn't play the forward pass, had to come back for the penalty. And
let's take the scrum.
Great decision.
A great position for a scrum as well. Midfield, in the centre of the field. So options right and left. We're going to have a couple of changes here for the Wanneroo team with 10 minutes left. They'll give some of their big guys like Andre Roux coming off now. He's got through a lot of work. He's been very good today for the Roux Dogs, and he's put in a good shift for them, and they'll be hoping that he is fit and ready to go next year and in a Roux Dogs jersey, because he's a real talent at front row.
Yeah, so Andre Roux and Jake Smith coming off, number 1 and number 25 respectively, and replaced by number 3 Chase Geary and number 2 Jesse Newcomb in the front row. So really good game by these boys for today. And a big scrum here by West Scarborough. Advantage play. They got house money just kicked forward. Picked up. Close
just
to the line.
They'll be looking one more just to give himself a little bit of a safety net against that breakaway try against Roux Dogs. 8 minutes left. And that's Big McLennan with the pick and go. He's just short. Ball's in there somewhere, and
has he given it a try, Jason? I think Jordan Kaminsky has awarded a try there,
has,
Jason.
Yeah, I'm surprised there wasn't much celebration about it. So, right, I think that might have been.
Yes, he's awarded a try, but we can't see who. Pick a number.
Is it Walker or? Look, it was someone wearing a West Scarborough jersey, and that will just ease the nerves a little bit, that they've got a bit of protection now for that bonus point and for that home semi-final, that if the Roux Dogs come back into it with 7 minutes left on the clock. But I actually don't think that the score probably reflects how competitive the Roux Dogs have been in this game, because they've actually been very competitive. And again, the West Scarborough team would have had some nerves there, because the Roux Dogs can certainly.
Billy Brown's off, man. 20. Billy's there, mate.
Just my co-commentator just having a bit of a chat with the West Scarborough bench there. We were trying to find out who the try scorer was in that one, and nobody seemed to know. So, again, it's all. Oh, look at this big run.
James
galloping.
Walker.
Yeah, Walker. He's got, gives it now to Vuitaverta.
Simi loves a carry. Kolteka. Tinamana. Matthew James. Callum Young looking for a try. Beats one. Just taken down short of the line. Everyone's looking. And a goal line dropout held up over the line. So West Scarborough attacking from everywhere now.
Coming home with a wet sail, aren't they? And that's why standing coach Dwayne Grace wasn't too stressed.
I think being
have that bonus point, I think he was like, "Don't worry, we're going to come home strong," and they certainly have done that. And the Roo Dogs now probably feeling the last 21 and a half rounds of rugby in those legs.
I think Dwayne Grace being in Broome for the last 12 months is where the lack of stress comes from, Jason.
Well, that'll do it.
And big Matthew James.
Big strong carry there. Got two guys squaring up to each other. And it's actually resulted in the Roo Dogs winning that battle because they've turned the ball over.
Yeah, young Hayden also up, Jason, getting over the ball, number four with the blue headgear, getting hands on the ball and not letting go. Really, really good steal by that young guy. He'll be happy with himself there for that one. Chalk it up on the stats.
It's coming right at us and over the heads. And the Roo Dogs have four more minutes left in this game to entertain the 5 minutes left. I was trying to get out of here early, beat the parking, but it is 5 minutes and
big Jeremy Thrush doesn't need a lifter.
Who's gone the distance in this game. He's lasted it, so penalty there for the Roo Dogs being offside. West Scarborough will have
gonna go for a line out here, which is a good option. And no doubt their forward pack will want to get hands on the ball and try and maul this one. Little group huddle. Slow to the line, Nick McClendon to the front. And Nico Maniena to the back. Six-man line out here, Jason. So option for the ball. No, five-man line out with the nine standing out in the back line. Leslie steps in front. Let's go straight to him. He calls it to himself.
Oh, nice little trick play. I don't know if it was a trick play or a misconnection, but it worked. Jeremy Thrush shovels it over to Walker. Gives it back to Thrush. Basketball pass out to Koteka. He's met well in the tackle by the Roo Dogs. And West have gone backwards. If they will be keen just to keep the ball in hands here. Nothing silly towards the enders. Simi is cut down in the tackle. Might have got a touch isolated there. He goes in and plays makeshift halfback. And
to Atara. Picks and dummies and goes. Gives it wide. Matthew James, Maniena, running like a centre. Sets it up. We've got Yuvari Tinamana on the boot. Great little
to
bounce
Grace.
To Pinny Grace. What is he doing? Oh, no.
Oh, no. I think it's... Do you think he was in front of the man when he kicked it? So, but they did have a penalty there, and Walker throws it out to Leslie, who is met by Bully.
Not rolling away. They got Haas money here. Koteka, Matthew James, straight up the guts. Quick play inside ball. McLennan,
the big man. You can hear the home support getting behind him, and he has scored the try. So just raw size for West Scarborough, and they put the icing on the cake. And the boys on the bench are all standing, getting ready to celebrate the fact that they are going to have a home semi-final next week here at Bennett Park. I reckon that I think their reserve grade might be in the shouts of semi-finals as well. So should be a good day down here next week. They'll play the students at UWA. That'll be an absolutely cracking game, that one. And so it'll finish as Palmyra, the minor premiers this year. They will take on associates, given that they are winning their game. And that is it. Referee Kaminsky says that'll do us for today, and that will do us for the Fortescue Premier Grade regular season. Dane Lazarus, it's been an absolute pleasure commentating with you across the different grades on YouTube this year. Some of us got recognised for that in a promotion from time to time up to the stand game, but that's okay. And look forward to joining you on commentary probably next season. And I'm really, really looking forward to knockout footy next week from us. here at Bennett Park. My name is Jason Marrable. This is Dane Lazarus, and we will see you next time.